Hi everyone, welcome again to this channel. Today I am going to explain you how you will create EMI calculator with the help of UiPath app in some simple steps. So if you are new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Let's start with creating EMI calculator. So before starting with complete creation of your EMI calculator, let me give you some insight about the EMI calculator. So whenever we are interested to take a loan, any type of loan, home loan or personal loan, and when we will visit on any banking site for the loan request and we want to calculate the interest rate and the principal amount and the rate of interest at them, that time EMI calculator will act as a intermediator for showing us the detail. So you can find it on any of the website, even on the Policy Bazaar and several other sites. But you can also create your own EMI calculator and use it for your reference. You can also use this application in your organization purpose or any specific independent requirement. So let me show you how we'll create it in some simple step with complete configuration step. So please be alert from start to end of this tutorial so that you are able to understand each and every steps in detail. For creating any application or EMI calculator, we just have to log in to cloud.uipath.com where we can click on apps. So let me show you from the beginning. So when we'll click on the apps, we're able to create the app section. I'm not going into basic steps. I've already covered in one of my sessions. You can refer it from the description tab. So let me start creating a new app. We just have to click on create. I've already created. So let me show you how we'll edit it or how we'll enter more details. So this is the container which I drag and drop from add new controls where I can find different controls are available. This is the label or header, you can see that. This is the label which I drag and drop and mention the detail. So you can find out the labels here. I dragged it and just change the detail or update the detail. So you can find out here. So text I changed to loan amount. I did not change anything else. Rest all is same. Then I drag and drop text boxes. So you can find it out in text boxes in input panel. So this is my text box. I dragged off. And after that, I made the changes in general. So you can see here, I've added here. I've just added for hint purpose for the user. So you can see here, INR. So let me remove this. I will explain you later on. So in all three text boxes, I've added here a hint section. And same thing did it for labels as well. Here I added one text area where I want to show my complete passage and one button I dragged and drop. So this will become our front end. For working logic, we will need one more component from UiPath Studio. In UiPath Studio, I've created one sequence where I drag and drop three input dialog box. In all three input dialog box, one by one I've entered the detail which I will need on my calculator. So first section I've added here one enter tenure, so where tenure will be entertained, and for this I've created arguments which contain input and output section. So you can see all four arguments are created here. Now next I have added here the enter amount and ROI. So you can see in the result section I have added here amount and ROI both. Next I have assigned the logic. So I simply added or simply describe the result section where ROI is multiplied by tenure. But whenever we are talking about EMI calculator is not working with this logic. They are having several other logics which will be calculated based for total interest and principal and interest amount. But I kept it simple so you can add it according to your requirement. So this is the multiplication section. You can use the arguments which we have defined or selected from input dialog box. At the end, I present it on my message box. If you want to remove it, you can. Otherwise, keep adding it. So whenever we are using our UiPath apps, this will pop up one message. So it's don't worry about if you want, you can remove it. After doing all this, I just published. So once I will publish, my orchestrator should be connected here. So you can see here my orchestrator connected. If you want to see how we'll connect it, please watch my previous session. So I've already published, so I'm showing you how you can do that. Just click on next. Don't need to edit anything. Just keep in mind your package name should be rememberable. So once you click on the publish, that package should be published. I've already published here. I don't want to publish it again. Next section, I will go to my orchestrator login where I have to provide the process detail or package detail. Just logged out because I kept my session. So click here. So once I click on my login, it will login my orchestrator account where I can see the complete set over there. I just have to upload packages. So go to processes. Inside the processes, this is my already running. So for you, just click on add where you will get a pop-up. From here, you can update whatever packages you have published. So once you click on this and click on create, it will create a new package for you, and for running you just have to select this and run. Now we have done till here, so let's go to our main page app studio where we have to define the arguments value on each field. So here you can see here there is no bindings are available. For binding we have to assign the value. So here I am expecting the amount. I am giving here an input amount. For ROI, it's already there. So you can do that for the same way. And for month, you can do that for the same. That is for the tenure. At the final step, the same thing we will need it for this. We have to add the result because I want to publish my result here. For the submit button, we just have to click create process. When we'll click on the process, we have to enter or provide the process detail. So click on this, select your processes and packages already selected. Because of that, I'm not selecting it again. Cancel this. Once we'll select and click on it, it will configure your all the parameters like this. UiPath apps debug laptop. So this thing is already configured for me. For you, just click on plus tab and use this. Now everything is set. Let's go to main page where we can get our calculator tab. So in calculator tab, we have to provide our bindings or sorry. So we don't need to provide here a binding. We will use here event. I've already created one edit rules where just have to let me delete this and do it for you. Start process. Inside the start process, click on this and drag and drop. So confirmation purpose, we are going to use here this process is started. So once our process will start, it will show a message for us. So let me show you the complete message. Change the title here. This process is started. And same thing, we can do that for end or complete. So when it complete, you again select the show message. And in this tab, provide the detail. Completed. Now we have done. Better to select unattended. This will be required component and major important part we are going to cover here. For running all these requirements, you have to download one JSON file or .js file. So it's robot UiPath robot.js. From here you have to download one JS file and keep in your project folder. You can also configure it, but better to use downloaded container. Click on this, it will download .js file. After downloading, copy and paste inside your project folder. So I've created my project name is UiPath app. I've created one folder script where I kept my UiPath robot. Without that, it will not work. Better to keep that file before publishing. Now we are set to run. We have done all this. Let's run the calculator page and see the result. So for running, you can directly publish, that is available for everyone publicly, or you can click on preview. So once you'll click on preview, it is available for your private action. You can use it. So here I'm entering 45,000. ROI is 7%. And 10 year I want to keep for 12 months. So you can see once I hit on calculator, it will show me message the process is started. It will go to our UiPath where it will run the complete execution, and after execution is completed, it will show us a message where we can get the value in between these box. So let's wait for the execution. Now you can see the pop-up message where I need to enter tenure. So tenure I want to take it here as a 12, and then again it will pop up for the ROI. Okay, and enter amount. So I am keeping here at the same amount. Now you can see message is available. So let's go to this page. Now you can see it is completed and we are getting value 84 here. So by this way, we can create an EMI calculator application. So it's totally dependent on your logic, how it is working and the value is correct or not. So whatever logic we will provide in assign section, you will get same amount here, because we have directly multiplied with the ROI and tenure amount, which is not at all possible to have the same EMI amount here, because we have loan amount 45,000. So it's up to us. We can change the logic, but the flow is same. So you can create an EMI calculator with a simple step. So as you can see that while creating, we did not use a single line of code. It will be automatically created for us by using UiPath app. That's the advantage of using these type of application and creating our required application in few clicks. So let's recap this. We have started with creating a flow in UiPath Studio where we have created the logic or sequence. Then we jump to our App Studio where we have created the front end, drag header section, three labels, three text boxes, one button and one text area where we want to show our data or message. After that, we have published our package into Orchestrator where if we want to, we run it. Otherwise, we can just go to and create the process. For creating a process, after creating, we have assigned one event where once we will click on the calculator tab, it will calculate according to our logic and show us in response. We have also saw that for running all this, we will need robot.js.uipod.com. This package will be required inside our project. So this is all about creating an EMI calculator using UiPath app. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you really like the content of this video, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. Thank you for watching.